I want you to picture this scene. First thing in the morning on your typical work day. Snooze. Not doing it. 5 precious minutes later. No. 5 more minutes. Okay. Got you peeling yourself off the sheets. Your feet hit the floor. But see, now you're 15 minutes behind schedule. At that point, what are your chances of stopping, preparing, and eating a healthy breakfast? Zero or less. At that point, what are your chances of throwing on your workout clothes, exercising? That's not happening. At that point, what are your chances of being a calm and encouraging leader for your family? Hey, listen, you don't have to admit it. We've all been there. In the morning, it's rush, rush, rush. It's go, go, go. Until you squeal into the parking lot at work, spray gravel, caffeine in hand. The caffeine goes down and you become a productivity machine. I mean, emails done, to-dos, check, 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 call, 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 call. But see, here's the thing. About 9:15, you start getting a little hungry. You start doing what I call cubicle trick-or-treating. Basically, that's you making up excuses to talk to other people so you can get the stuff on their desk. You know who's got the stuff, right? You see, but here's the problem with that. Most research tells us that from 9 a.m. to 11 a.m. is the 2 most productive hours of your day. In particular, for salespeople, if you make your sales calls from 9 a.m. to 11 a.m., your closing rate is significantly higher, and in some cases, higher than if you made calls the entire rest of the day. So it's a peak moment. It's a peak productivity moment. But right in the middle of it, you get distracted. You get hungry. You get up, and then you land back at your desk with a little cubicle trick-or-treating in your system. And what does that do to our ability to be on top of our game? Right? So, but then you're a professional. You can't stop. You don't. You get a little momentum going again. You go, okay, you take whatever willpower, energy, you push yourself over that barrier. You get a little momentum going. All right, this is me. I'm back. Until about 11 o'clock. And what do you start thinking about at 11 o'clock? Lunch, right? How can you eat all that stuff and be hungry an hour and a half later? But see, we are. Okay, now think about it. With that momentum behind you, with those choices behind you, with that energy behind you, you land at lunch, and then there's the big gut bomb burger. What are your chances of passing on that? That's not happening either. You land back at your desk. What's your energy level? What's your state at that point? You see, it's not you. That's not the real you sitting at that desk at that moment. But see, then again, you're professionals. You don't stop. You can't. You summon up whatever willpower, energy you've got left, absorb whatever stress is necessary to push yourself over that barrier. All right. And then you get a little something going again. All right. Okay. I'm back until 2:55 p.m. At 2:55, you start thinking, man, my neck hurts. I'm getting a little bit of that twinge right here. You start at 2:59, you start thinking, what is wrong with me? And then 3 o'clock, it's as if this wall comes up. Pow! You see, me living with those choices, with that momentum behind me, I hit that wall running 90 miles an hour, hair on fire. Pow! And now, who's sitting at your desk at that point? It's not the best you. It's not the best me. I hate that. But then again, you can't stop. You don't. You summon up whatever willpower, energy, take whatever stress is necessary. You lift yourself up and you push yourself over that barrier as well. And you get a little momentum going again. Until about 5:30, 6, whatever time Elvis leaves the building. And you drive home. Now, you're driving home and you're thinking, man, I love my significant other. You know, they've done so much for me. When I get home, I'm going to tell them how much they mean to me, what they've done for me. And you get out of your car and you walk inside. And as soon as you open the door, you see dog poop. Honey, the dog has pooped in the floor. I'm not picking it up. I didn't want the dog. You wanted the dog. Kids, turn off the television. Would someone please take care of this? I mean, how can you go from love you, love you, love you to snap, hair trigger, just like that? You see, I believe that we've got these underlying chemical reactions inside of our physiology that are connected to our psychology that inhibit our state, who we are at any given moment. And I tell you what, our state drives our decisions. Okay, so then you get home. You know, where 9 to 11 was your two most productive hours of the day, I tend to believe that 6 to 8 p.m. is likely the two most important hours of your day. It's at that point when you get the opportunity to connect with. You see, it's my opportunity to connect with my wife who needs me at that point in time. It's my opportunity to connect with my little 4-year-old Bella Core, my little 12-week-old Camille Core. They need me at that point. But you see, with those decisions, with that momentum behind me, with that state that I land home in, all I want to do is this, this, and this. Right now, I don't know if you've caught it or not yet, but I'm from Arkansas. Y'all hear that? Yeah. You know, just as an aside, you may not know this. Arkansas was recently the second most unhealthy state in the entire country. In Arkansas, gravy is a beverage. Hey, being that we're the second most unhealthy state in the country, what do we say in Arkansas? Does anybody know? Thank God for Mississippi. Being from Arkansas, I know poor health choices. My sister-in-law, she's always complaining about she's gained all this weight because of her baby. Baby, he's 19. It's the baby back ribs, honey. Hey, I like to tell that. It's true, but it's a joke. I like to tell that because, you know, really, the solution for us to move from knowing we should live a healthier way of life, a more balanced way of life, to doing it does not come down to scare tactics. Right? I tease my fellow health experts. I say, you know, listen, guys, awareness campaigns can be very effective if the people are unaware. If they're already aware and we continually hit them over the head with the same things that they should be doing and that they're not doing, what is that? Annoying at best, demotivating at worst. You see, now, the awareness thing that I'm talking about is not about knowing your numbers. It's not, I'm not talking about health risk appraisals, biometrics, health promotion. Now, that's a totally different awareness that most people don't have, and they need us to show them how important that is. And we'll talk just a little bit more about that. But let's jump back to that day, okay, where you land home at 6 to 8, you want to engage with your family, but you're just out of juice. You sit down and it's dinner time and you eat like it's your last supper. You get up, spend a little bit more time with your family, and then it's time for bed. I don't know, 10, 11, 12, whatever time you go to bed. You lay down and one of two things happens. The first is you lay down and you fall asleep within 3 seconds. Who are my people that fall asleep when they stop moving? I'm one of those. See, my wife, she's the opposite, though. She's one of those people who can be completely exhausted, completely stressed out, lay down, be exhausted, and can't sleep. How can that be? How is that possible? Is that necessary? You see, I don't think it is. I don't think most of that is necessary. Or maybe you're the part 2A, where you lay down, fall asleep, but wake up at 2 o'clock and can't go back to sleep. You see, now that's not necessary either. All right, okay, so then you finally get down, you're finally sleeping, and then a few precious hours later, we begin that 24-hour cycle again. You see, when it comes to getting the edge, when it comes to improving your quality of life, your ability for productivity, performance, profitability, when it comes to improving your persuasiveness to other people, your health, what I believe is that your most powerful tool is this 24-hour package you get every day. And if you take that 24-hour package and you engineer it just a little bit better, it can help you avoid those barriers that we hit almost every day that sabotages our energy, our willpower, our optimism, our motivation. We can overcome most of that with some small changes.